Hey guys, how's it going? Today I'm going to show you how to tell if your car has a bad battery or a bad alternator. This video is going to be a two-part video, so in the part one, we're looking at the battery. So let's get started! Every car has a battery and an alternator. The battery is the main power source for your car, and the alternator is there to produce electricity to maintain the charge of the battery. Every time you start the car, the first thing you need is a good battery. So when you try to start the car, if you hear a clicking noise or the headlights or maybe your dashboard lights goes dim or your radio restarts or even the clock goes dim or if you notice your engine is cranking slower than usual or maybe nothing happens at all and you get a battery warning light, then you almost always have a weak battery. If you only hear one click as you turn the key and then your dashboard lights turns off, then you are likely to have a weak connection on the battery terminals, if it is not a weak battery. Now let's see how to test the battery to see if it's bad. And I'm going to show you guys 4 ways to test a battery, using a multimeter, a load tester, an OBD2 scanner, and a hydrometer. Let's begin with the multimeter. First thing you want to do is to turn the headlights on for at least 30 seconds. This will remove any surface charge the battery may have. Then you want to turn the dial into 20 DC volts and connect the red lead to the positive battery terminal and the black lead to the negative battery terminal. If the reading is 12.6 volts or above, then the battery is fully charged. If the reading is less than 12.4 volts, then the battery needs recharging. In some cars, you'll get a warning for this. If you can get your car to start, then let the engine run for at least 30 minutes so the alternator will charge the battery. If your car doesn't start, then you'll have to connect the battery to a battery charger. If you don't have a battery charger, you'll have to take it to a battery shop to have it recharge. You can also try to jump start the car, but I'll get to that later. Measuring the voltage is only telling you the state of charge of the battery. You also want to measure how much current it can put out. This is measured by coil cranking amps, and your battery has a label saying how much coil cranking amps your battery has. You want to do this test only on a fully charged battery. What you want to see is the voltage drop on the battery as you start the car, and it shouldn't drop below 9.6 volts. As you can see, I have set up 2 multimeters for the test. As you can see, the voltage on the battery did not drop below 9.6 volts, so this battery is good. Or is it? Multimeters have a latency, which means they take some time to process the voltage into numbers. Inside the battery, it only takes a few microseconds for the voltage to drop down. This professional multimeter I have here records voltage variances in microseconds. So let's see what is the actual voltage drop on the battery. As you can see, the voltage on the battery has actually dropped down to 8.8 volts, which is much lower than the 9.6 volts mark. So I would say this battery is bad and will need a replacement soon. That's how you test a battery using a multimeter. The only downside is that a professional multimeter like this can be very expensive, which brings us to the second method of testing a battery, which is using a load tester. For this test, you're gonna get a load test like this. You're gonna connect the leads to the battery. Then I'm gonna set up this for 430 coil cranking amps, which is what this battery is rated for. As you can see, it only has 251 coil cranking amps, which confirms the results from the multimeter that this is a bad battery. So if you're looking for a reliable way to test your battery, it is highly recommended to buy one of these testers. They are very inexpensive. Now, if your battery is bad, and if it is a maintenance-free battery, there's nothing you can do. You just have to replace it. If you have a serviceable battery like this, then you want to take off the caps once in a while and see if the battery is having enough water inside. If it is too low, you can use some distilled water to top up. Inside the battery, there are a number of cells, and the water level should be above the cells at all times. If the water level is too low, then the exposed cells will start to sulfate, which will weaken the battery performance. The cells should be clean. If you see a lot of sulfation around the cells, you can try some battery conditioner to clean them. If the sulfation is very minor, this will enhance the condition of the battery for a few more months before it finally goes out. Here's a perfect example of an extreme sulfation inside a battery. As you can see, all the cells are covered in a frothy residue and it is too late for this battery. Remember, batteries have very strong acid inside, so make sure you wear some good chemical resistant gloves and some proper eye protection before you start any testing. And always have some baking soda water mixture by side So in case if you happen to get in contact with some acid, you can immediately use baking soda to neutralize the acid and then use plenty of water to wash the contact area. Now we have come to the third method of testing a battery, which is using hydrometer. This device measures the specific gravity inside the battery. You want to have 1.275 or above reading in each cell. Any lower than that means your battery is going bad. As you can see, in this battery, we are just on the margin, which means the battery is about to go bad. In a battery, there are 6 cells, and each cell can contribute to the total amount of cold cranking amps the battery can produce. So you want to check each cell. If you find more than a 0.05 of a difference in the hydrometer reading, then your battery has a bad cell. Again, you can add some treatment to see if that's gonna help, and if it doesn't, then the battery is going bad. Now we have come to the final method of testing a battery, which is using an OBD2 scan tool. For this, you need to get an OBD2 scanner that can read live data. You wanna plug the scanner into the OBD2 port, turn the key to the on position, and even select the control module voltage. We have a 12.3 on the scanner, and if you compare this to the multimeter reading, it has 12.4 volts. The 0.1 volts drop is due to the resistance in the circuits and the wiring in between. And this confirms that we have a good connection between the battery and the car's computer. And 0.1 volts drop is acceptable for this car. Then you want to start the car and check the voltage drop on the battery. As you can see, we have 9.9 volts, so if you add that 0.1 volts drop, we actually have 10 volts on the battery, so that is about the 9.6 mark. So we can make sure that this battery is good. If we compare this against the multimeter reading, we have exactly 10 volts, which confirms the results from the scanner. That's how we properly test a battery in a car. There are other methods to test a battery, but you need very expensive equipment for that. Next, you want to see if the battery has a good connection on the terminals. So you want to load test the terminals. Get your multimeter again and connect the red lead to the battery post and the black lead to the terminal. Then you want to start the car. And see the voltage drop between the battery post and the terminal. It shouldn't be more than 0.5 volt on both terminals. As you can see, I only have a few millivolts on both terminals, which is extremely good. This is a perfect example showing how important it is to have a good connection on the battery terminals. This is a dead car, and as you can see, there's nothing happens as I turn the key. But if you go to the battery, it looks like it has a very strong connection, but this terminal is shorted out internally, and I can't even light up a test light. So in this case, the battery is good, but the terminal is bad, so it needs a new terminal. It is also very important to keep the battery terminals clean from corrosion, especially in modern car batteries, because sometimes you can't even see the corrosion. To clean the terminals, get a sandpaper, or a wire brush, or get a terminal cleaner like this. Then take off the terminals, and clean them both inside and out. Once you're done, put it back on and apply some silicone paste. This will keep the moisture from contacting the terminals for a long time. Modern cars are very sensitive to battery voltage, so if you have to take your battery terminals off, either to clean them or to replace the battery, it is highly recommended to get a memory saver like this. Before you take off the battery terminals, you want to plug this into the OBD2 port and connect the other end to a battery charger, so your car's computer wouldn't lose its memory. Now you can safely take off the terminals. Same story goes with the jump start. Most cars can be jump started, but there are some modern cars that doesn't allow you to jump start. So make sure to follow your car's owner's manual before you jump start. And the top tip for this video is always have some jumper cables in your car. Or even better, get a jump starter like this. They are real handy, and you can jump start the car by yourself without needing another car. Thanks for checking out this video, and remember to watch the part 2, where I'm going to show you guys how to tell if you have a bad alternator. And also, if you haven't subscribed, consider subscribing to the Junky DIY Guy channel so you will never miss another video. All the tools I've used in this video are in the description down below, so you can easily find them. And I'll see you in the next one.